Hi, my name is Sam Johnson and I'm a voice teacher. Today I will be reacting to and analyzing the Mariah Carey and Ariana Grande and Jennifer Hudson video, Oh Santa. This video is sponsored by ExpressVPN. A VPN, or virtual private network, creates a secure tunnel between you and the internet so that other people can't get their hands in and steal all of your packets. If you are concerned about security online and you're not using a VPN, what are you doing? Really, what are you doing? Your ISP can see everything that you do online. US ISPs can legally sell your data to ad companies. Governments, large corporations, and websites constantly surveil you and harvest your data for their own agendas. ExpressVPN puts a stop to that by encrypting all your data and hiding your location. VPNs can help you access thousands of new shows and movies that aren't currently available in your country. For example, you might live in the USA, and you might really want to watch Fargo, and you want to go to Netflix to watch Fargo, but you can't watch Fargo. So you can say that you're in Canada using ExpressVPN and watch Fargo. Find out how you can get 3 months free by clicking the link in the description. ExpressVPN.com/Sam Johnson. It's easy to remember because my name is Sam Johnson. Thank you again to ExpressVPN for your continuing support. Okay, cool. So I know I usually don't react to processed music, to things that are at least not pretending to be live, but I wanted to do this anyway because I think that there's still a lot that we can learn from watching three really good singers sing. So far, I really like the way that their voices have sounded in unison. So unison means singing all the same line rather than if one of the singers or two of the singers was singing a different line, a harmony. I also like that we were able to hear Ariana and Jennifer come in on the same line so that we could hear their different vocal timbre, their different vocal quality. You could hear that Ariana has a slightly lighter voice, Jennifer has a little bit more body to her voice, but they were both singing the same pitch, and I do think that it's really important to hear how on the same pitch different instruments can sound totally different, and so it's unfair for us to try to ask ourselves to sound like someone else. For people learning how to sing, some of that requires us finding vocal models that are similar to us because we will naturally try to imitate other singers. But it's also just important to recognize so that we don't always try to sound like someone that we're not. Amazing, and I bet that you can bring me back my baby, because every time I say Christmas lights, I feel this void inside and I just can't take it. I saw them shopping last week. Yeah, we're getting really great textural variety going back and forth between Mariah, who is also singing with a little bit more body, and Ariana, who's singing just a really breathy back sound. And we all know that Ariana's capable of doing a more full sound, and so that shows that this is just a musical decision to make everything kind of less boring, because if everyone was singing the exact same all the way through, then it would be quite boring. So the mouth didn't match up very well. I'm sure that they're singing. Her vowels just didn't match up as perfectly what she was doing with what we could see with what was happening with the audio, which we know. It's an obvious thing. This is a music video. She's probably singing, but they're not editing the take that they did the video with. That said, I do think that with her mouth moving the way that she just moved it, it's a really good example of how to move your mouth when you're singing a song. And if you had watched that clip with the audio muted, you probably wouldn't know what pitches she was trying to hit. And that's because it doesn't look like she's trying to force any of these pitches out. She's just keeping a nice round mouth. She's getting a lot of jaw dropping. Everything is just here. And she could be singing a super high note or a super low note, and that vowel shape would work quite well. love seeing just like Mariah fade into the background of it where like her finger was disappearing and stuff. She's the queen of Christmas though. Oh my gosh. I don't think that this song is going to be like historically as well received as All I Want for Christmas, which is probably the best Christmas song ever. And it's just incredible that someone with as awesome of a career as she has aside, that like she could have made an entire career off of just that one song. And I don't think this is just trying to like be a repeat of that and like, hey, I want to make another $500 million off of one song over the next 30 years. But like, it's a fun song and you can tell that she just loves Christmas. Really good example. Like, you could mute this and you wouldn't have any idea what note she's singing. And I kind of love that she's doing that rather than making it look extra for the music video, rather than going, oh, she's just doing it how she'd sing it. And it works incredibly well. J-Hud is a great singer. I think that she's just like perpetually underrated in terms of commercial activity, but like everyone who loves voices is like, I like Jennifer Hudson. You can't say everyone, but like really everyone does. And so I think that looking at these great singers of what things they do that we can see give us good things to kind of imitate and to work on in our own voices. So you could go watch yourself sing a song in the mirror and just see if your face looks similar to that. Are you going like this all the time? Are you going like this all the time? Are you going like this all the time? And I think that if you were able to make your face match what she's doing, everything else would probably like feel a little bit better. There's an internal portion of vowels that we can't really see, and that's where having a well-trained ear comes into play, where you can hear different qualities of the vowel so that you can kind of ask for those qualities or ask for a physical thing to change internally to get those qualities. But a big part of it really is just external. But especially for beginner singers, if you're able to just change what the mouth looks like, just change the architecture of the front of the mouth, it makes tremendous differences. And then once you get used to what that new balanced feeling feels like, then you're able to kind of do other things with the front of your mouth and keep the internal part a little bit more even. But I like that even a fantastic singer like Jennifer is sticking to things that work really well, even in a music video. I promise that I won't forget the milk and cookie. The trees all sparkling and gold. But inside I feel so cold. So soon as you live no more. Then I want you to come and make it mine this Christmas. So a very similar thing happened with Mariah, where we probably wouldn't be able to tell what note she was singing if she didn't do that thing with her hand that she does every time that she sings whistle notes. Like, it's not forcing for these notes. And the more relaxed you look, the more relaxed you feel, the more likely it's going to be that you're going to be able to sing something super well. I don't love music videos. I loved that harmony. Like, we don't hear that ever. Two singers who are usually good enough at singing in whistle tone usually don't sing together because they're like usually stars. I loved that. I thought that was fantastic. I would love just a full album of them only duetting in whistle tone. And then we don't need any of that mid-range stuff. So main takeaways, it's important to look as relaxed as you possibly can when you're singing and to feel as relaxed as you possibly can when you're singing. The other main takeaway is I love whistle tone harmonies. I think they sound great. I love it's just such an interesting tone that we don't really get ever. I haven't heard that before. I loved it. I think it was fantastic. I also love that, you know, when Ariana started her music career, everyone was saying, well, she's baby Mariah. And so it's so fun to see them sing something together, utilizing, you know, their niche so specifically. I think that's fantastic. And I am always going to love Jennifer Hudson and the things that she does with her voice. She just makes everything look effortless. Thank you for watching. Please like, subscribe, leave a comment below. Show me some other clips of people singing in whistle voice with other people also singing in whistle voice. Whistle voice duets. Drop them in the comments. Go check out the links. Thank you so much. Have a Merry Christmas.